Namaskaram. Today I am going to explain about cell is the basic unit of life. So I am a biology teacher from modern school. I am explaining cell is the basic unit of life. So everyone known that previous classes we learned that cell is the basic unit of what means mainly all the organisms are made up of cells. So cell is the basic unit. Without cell no organism can survive. So these are the topics we known before that. So how there is no building without bricks and cement, like that there is no organism without cell and a cementing like substance between the cells called matrix. So the same like that, every cell is important for the life of an organism. But here we are saying that first about history of cell, means who are the scientists contributed to discover about the cell and what about that, and among that about the history. If you have seen that, in 1665 one of the scientists is named Colossan, Robert Hooke. He discovered cell. He is the first scientist who discovered cell. But it is in this Latin language, what means cell means a little room. And he observed that, Robert Hooke observed that in a cork. He taken a dissection, a small cork. Cork means a dried wood substance like that. So he dissected that, cutting a slice and kept under microscope, and he observed that they contain small little room like structures. He observed that under microscope, he observed they contain small little room like structures. In Latin language it is called, little room is called cell. So this is the word how cell is formed. So that is a cell is the basic why how this discovered that. Next, after that another scientist is named Colossan, Robert Brown. What he identified means he identified nucleus. So nucleus is one of the important organelle inside the cells. After that another scientist, his name Colossan, Sladen, and he stated that plants are made up of tissues and they contain cells. Means plants are also made up of cells was identified by this scientist. Another one, Theodore Schwann, is another scientist. He studied about animal tissues. Means animals are also made up of cells was identified by this scientist. And another scientist is named Colossan, Rudolf Virchow. And he stated that the process of cell division means it's called as an omnicellular decellular, means every cell coming from the pre-existing cell. Suppose I came from my parents, they came from their parents, they came from their parents. So like that pre-existing, before it is present, now it is not there. So from that a new cell is produced, from this again new two cells, from that again new two cells, like that it is going on. So that was identified by Rudolf Virchow. And at the same time, that means in 1835, these two scientists, Sladen and Schwann, those two together, they proposed one Colossan cell theory. What the cell theory states that, so in cell theory they had taken the statement of Rudolf Virchow and totally they proposed that the cell theory only 4 points. He explained in cell theory 4 points, main basic points. 4. 1, all the living organisms, all living organisms are made up of cells. So that is the first point. What he stated means all living organisms are made up of cells. So that is 1. 2, second thing, all the cells are made up of similar chemicals and metabolic activities. This means every cell is made up of similar chemicals. Every building is made up of similar bricks. Same like that, every cell is made up of same chemicals and metabolic activities. Metabolic activities means how we are having digestion, excretion, secretion, respiration. Like that, inside cells also they will do that work. So that they have same chemicals and metabolic activities. 2. 3rd 1. The third one saying that all the cells are coming from the pre-existing cells. What this scientist stated that they introduced into that. So every cell is coming from that of the pre-existing cells. 4th point. What he stated, 4th point means, they stated that all the functions of an organ depends upon the functions of the cells and their interactions. For example, if I am moving my hand, then how it is working means the cells which are present inside the hand all together do they work, and because of that I can move my hand, otherwise I can't move. So the function of an organ depends on the functions of the cells and their interaction. So these are the 4 points they introduced that in cell theory. So cell is the, because of cells only all living organisms are made up of. So all living organisms are made up of cells. So cell is the basic structural unit. That is, by taking that point we can say cell is the structural unit, because of cells only we have one shape, otherwise we don't have shape. So that it is a structural unit. 2, all the cells are made up of similar chemicals, same chemicals. Every cell contains, either plant cell, animal cell, whatever the cells, they contain similar chemicals and same metabolic activities, their functions. 3, every cell is coming from the pre-existing cell, before the cell they are coming. 4, the function of an organism depends upon the functions of the cells. So means if cells are doing function, then we are also doing function. If cells are arrest means they can't move, then we also can't move. So by taking this, we can say that cell is the functional unit. Because of the cells only we are also moving. If cells are moving, then we are moving. If cells are not moving, we can't move. So by taking these 2 points, what is that means? Cell is giving structure, cell is giving function. So that based on these 2 we consider, we say that cell is the structural and functional unit of living organisms. So every living organism is made up of cells, and every function of an organism depends upon the functions of the cells. So that we can say that cell is the basic structural and functional unit of living organisms. That's only called basic unit of life. So because of alive means because of that cells only. This was what the scientists have concluded about that by taking this. Okay. ప్రజల టీవీ